Yes, open up your books, first line. And today we are going to start with the chapter 100 Dresses 2. Okay, so 100 Dresses 2, it is in continuation with the previous chapter that we have read, that is 100 Dresses 1. Okay, so 100 Dresses 1, what you felt after reading this chapter? How you are feeling? What you felt about the girl Wanda, of course. How you are feeling? What? A poor girl who was targeted, right? Then you are also feeling sorry for her condition. She is so introvert that she always remained tight-lipped without speaking a word against her insult. She is never saying anything except the word that she has 100 dresses and all lined up in her closet, right? This is Wanda. And what about Maddie? What do you think of Maddie? Or what you feel about Maddie? She is also at one time a figure of pity, just at one time, when she felt that it is wrong that is being done with Wanda. Okay? And moreover, she wanted that this kind of behavior should not be met by her. Okay, she should not face this kind of disgrace. She should not face this kind of insult which she was going through, right? And ultimately, Peggy, who was not that bad as she was behaving with that of Wanda. She's not that bad. She was, of course, a good girl who was always saving children from being bullied. She would cry if you would see any animal suffering. But ultimately, why she is always teasing Wanda, it is just because of the reason that why she is saying that she has 100 dresses and daily she is wearing one pale dress. So here one question is that you can't stop anyone to dream. You can't rob off anybody of dreaming. You can't take someone's, you can say, will to dream. ड्रीम करने से तो नहीं हम किसी को रोक सकते ना. दिस इज व्हाट वांडा वाज डूइंग एंड वाज इट अ क्राइम? नो, इफ शी इज नॉट हैविंग दोस काइंड ऑफ 100 ड्रेसेस देन वी कांट स्टॉप हर ड्रीमिंग. दिस इज व्हाट शी वाज डूइंग. शी वाज एस्पायरिंग, शी वाज विशिंग टू हैव दोस 100 ड्रेसेस एंड दिस इज द प्राइस दैट शी हैज पेड फॉर हर 100 ड्रेसेस, फॉर हर ड्रीम ऑफ 100 ड्रेसेस दैट शी इज रियली फेसिंग दैट काइंड ऑफ डिसग्रेसफुल बिहेवियर at the hands of the other girls of the school. And moreover, she is also feeling bad. What kind of insulting remarks are given by the girls, right? So ultimately, Wanda is also representing a picture of the girl, of, you can say, picture of the child of every school, not of that particular school, of every school. Who is going through this kind of trauma, who is going through this kind of suffering. So this chapter, it is, you can say, superficially, it seems to be a story of a girl who is being trolled. But ultimately, what it is there? Ultimately, it is a chapter which is delivering and which is highlighting the theme of what? It is highlighting the theme of bullying, right? So 100 Dresses 1, it has emerged out to be quite successful in giving us a clear-cut picture of the two girls, of the, sorry, the three girls, Wanda, Peggy, and Maddie. Okay? We have come to the clear-cut picture. And ultimately, what they have done to Wanda, this has also been put forward to us. But ultimately, after that, what will happen when Wanda will leave the school? The story did not end there. It's not a happy ending that Wanda wins the competition and ultimately it was announced by the teacher. Everyone was happy. Everyone was here. Boys were whistling and they were stamping their feet onto the ground. And this is what? No. Ultimately, it is the one main thing that why Wanda left the school. That was pricking the conscience. Conscience means inner self of Peggy and Maddie, that they suffered a lot. Later on, what they will do? what they will do in order to repent, or what they will do in order to reform themselves. And were they be able to reform their behavior? Were they changed girls? And after Wanda, was there anybody who suffered from this kind of behavior? So this we are going to actually read in 100 Dresses 2. So let us start 100 Dresses 2. And you must have also known that there is new issuing of the circular by the CBSE regarding the syllabus, which is given for term 1 and term 2. Anyone of you acquainted with that? Got anyone? So tomorrow just remind me. It's in my that device. And ultimately, I will tell you which are the chapters. Okay? And luckily, we have done most of the chapters for term 1. Okay? So let us go for 100 Dresses 2. So, when the class was circling the room, the monitor from the principal's office brought Miss Mason a note. Miss Mason, who is Miss Mason? The teacher, the class teacher. So when the class was circling the room and they were just looking at all the drawings that were being hanging from one side to another of the room, better don't share the book, please. Don't touch the book, okay? Maintain gap. So then the monitor from the principal's office, he has brought maybe a peer outside. He must have given a note to be given to your class in charge. So he has brought a note to be given to Miss Mason. Yes, Miss Mason read it several times and studied it thoughtfully for a while, and then she clapped her hands. So now, Miss Mason, who was very sensible teacher, just see what little part is being played by Miss Mason in this chapter, but still we have come out, or we are able to formulate a complete image of a teacher. Okay, we are able to formulate a complete image of a teacher, that what kind of behavior is expected by the teacher. She is doing her part to reform the students, that what they should do and what they should not do. So when the note was brought, Miss Mason, she was reading that note carefully. She read it several times because something of not approved behavior or disapproved behavior was written there. She read it several times and then she studied it thoughtfully. Thoughtfully means this also tells about the teacher that she is not acting instantly. She first of all thinks that what this note contains and what action should be taken by her after reading that note. So this is the reason why she thoughtfully read it for some time and then she clapped her hands. She clapped her hands in this manner. What is the meaning? It means she wanted to grab the attention. She wanted to attract the attention of the students of the class. So, attention class, everyone back to their seats. So everyone who were moving here and there, you know, some of the students, they are never, you can say, sitting quietly in the class. They are moving here and there. And ultimately, they were immediately at their seats because now Miss Mason is going to announce something important. They have also come to know. When the shuffling of feet had stopped and the room was still and quiet, Miss Mason said, "I have a letter from Wanda's father and I want to read to you." So what she did, she has opened up the note and she has shown it like this. See, when the shuffling of the shoes, movement of the shoes, it had stopped and everything was quiet. Everyone was focused towards Miss Mason to see what she is going to announce. So at that time, what happened? She announced that, "Here is a note from, here is a letter from Wanda's father and I want to read it to you," because after reading that note, she has prepared her mind that she should read that note for the children in the class. Miss Mason stood there a moment and silence in the room grew sense and expectant. Expectant means they were expecting something. Okay, so there was silence. Silence prevailed in the class. Why there was silence? Because letter from Vanda's father. What he wants to tell? Vanda is not coming to the school. But what he actually wants to tell us. So the silence grew, and moreover, they were expecting, they wanted to know. Some students, they were also talking, whispering to each other, what is there in the letter? What Vanda's father is going to tell through this letter? So the teacher adjusted her glasses slowly and deliberately means teacher adjusted her glasses on her eyes deliberately, and you can say slowly means she wanted to deliver the feeling that something important is going to be told here. Okay, and her name indicated what was coming. Sorry, her manner indicated that what was coming. This letter from Vanda's father was a matter of great importance. Everybody listened closely as Miss Mason read the brief note. So, through her gestures, through her expressions, she is going to deliver this feeling that something important is going to be discussed in the class. This is not a normal letter which she is going to read for everyone, but this is something important. And finally, everyone else was also quite expectant to see what actually this letter contains, what actually is written in this letter. So finally, you can see the content of the letter, what it is written here. So what his father has written in the letter: dear teacher, my Vanda will not come to your school anymore. That Vanda will not come to school anymore. Jake also, and his and her brother also. Now we move away to Big City. No more holler pollack means no more calling of names, no more insults, no more ragging, no more making fun, and no more ask why funny name. Plenty of funny names in the Big City. Yours truly, and is Jan Petrovsky. So through only these four lines, he has clearly mentioned that what he actually wanted to deliver. Okay, he wanted to tell that in the school there was lot of insult that was being felt by Vanda, and moreover her brother, because they were having unique name, and moreover such a long name, Vanda Petrovsky. But ultimately, as my children, they have faced a lot of insult here in this school. Now we are moving to some other big city where number of people are having these kind of names. This also means that number of Polish people, they have immigrated there, and there won't be any kind of fun making that will be involved there. Okay, so a deep silence met the reading of this letter. Now, you know, yes, letter is, my Vanda will not come to your school anymore. Jake also, his father said that Vanda will not come to the school now because we have shifted to a new city. Moreover, her brother Jake is also not coming here. Okay, and we move away to a big city. Here we are, we move away, we have gone to a big city where no holler pollack means we are no this kind of insult, we are not any this kind of, you can say, fun making, and where nobody will face these kind of, you can say, insults. Okay, because there are number of people who are having these kind of long names and unique names, and they won't suffer any kind of insult in the school now. So a deep silence met the reading of this letter. So when this letter was read, there was deep silence. Everyone was looking, you know, like, otherwise, so what is happening? Everyone is doing this thing. Everyone was making fun of Vanda. But what actually happens in the situation is that when the matter comes to the authorities, to the teacher or to the head of the institution, what is the usual reaction of the children? They would look at each other. Yes, Natalie is like that. मैंने तो कभी नहीं उसको कुछ कहा, राइट? बट एक्चुअली इन रियलिटी सब उसमें इन्वॉल्व होते, राइट? दिस वाज द behavior of the children. They were looking at each other's faces, and they were also felt very bad that what kind of utensil result their fun has produced, that their prank has resulted or their prank has turned into such a serious matter that Vanda has left the school. They did not know what to do and what kind of expression they should deliver. So, Miss Mason took off her glasses, blew on them, and wiped them on her soft white handkerchief. So, Miss Mason, so what she did, like she was having her glasses over her head, she took off her glasses, blew some air over them, and cleaned it. Actually, she wanted to see the reaction of the children. She actually wanted to ask children, now what? She is looking at them with questioning eye that it is only you people that has led to this kind of situation. It is just because of you only that Vanda has left the school. It is just because of that only that this kind of situation is being faced by Vanda. So, then she put them on again and looked at the class. When she spoke, her voice was very low. She was also feeling very bad that it was not at all in her knowledge that the matter has gone to that extent that one girl was forced to leave the school forever. She was also feeling very bad. She was also feeling at one point, or you can say, she was also feeling guilty of her, you can say, this act also, that as a teacher, she could have controlled that. She could have stopped that girl from leaving the school, because the consequences only the teacher knows. It is not easy to go to a new place, to adjust there, okay, to make new friends. She tried. She also felt so, she was thoughtful in the starting, because she knew the consequences of that letter. So, she was also very quiet. She was not speaking in high tone. She was also speaking very low voice, as she did not know what to do now. I'm sure that none of the boys and girls in room 13 would purposely and deliberately means knowingly, would purposely and deliberately hurt anyone's feelings because his or her name happened to be a long. Now, what is the generosity of behavior of the teacher is here? She knew what was being done. It was intentional. But she would never tell students that you are doing it knowingly. She was not trying to scold them. She wanted to make them feel intrinsically, deep from the core of their hearts, that what they have done was absolutely wrong. She wanted to prove them innocent, and she wanted to tell them that their innocence has brought greater and fatal results. So this is the reason what she said, that I know that in room number 13, that in this entire room, would purposely and deliberately hurt anyone's feelings because his or her name happened. So she said, I know that no boy and no girl in this room number 13 has with any purpose or deliberately means knowingly wanted to hurt someone's feeling because his or her name was little bit different from that of others, or it was longer than from others. So, and I prefer to think that what was said in thoughtlessness. And she wanted to end this matter. She thought, said to children that I feel that what you people have said was actually said in thoughtfulness, okay, thoughtlessness, without any thinking. Means what you thought, what consequences it will bear, or what you feel that what end it will produce, without only that, what you have done was done. But actually what was done was absolutely wrong. So, I know that all of you feel the way I do, that this is a very unfortunate thing to have happened, unfortunate and sad, the teacher said. But I would like to point out here that what has been done was absolutely wrong. This must not have been done because that was really bad, unfortunate and sad. Must not have been done. And I want you all to think about it. And what she wanted that everyone should think about it. Actually, that was really a big lesson for everyone. That their fun, it was not a lesson for all the children for room number 13. But actually, the writer wants to deliver this thing also, that sometimes our small acts can bring about bigger results. Such kind of results, unexpected results, which we are never aware of. And which, you can say, which after those results, sometimes we never get a chance to reform them. And this is what has happened with Vanda Panchomsky. She has left the school and all the children, they were so helpless. They would not have, they did not have even the chance to ask Vanda or to say Vanda a word, single word, that is sorry. Why? Because she has left the school. It means that kind of, you can say, behavior that was meted by her, or the kind of feeling that she has faced, or the kind of insult that she has gone through. It was really very sad. And she has gone, she has faced that kind of result to so much of extent that what she wanted, she never came to school. Okay, but she was so, you can say, she was so full of patience that she tolerated till the last day. And without knowing anybody, she left the school. So, the first period was the study period. Mary tried to prepare her lessons, but she could not put her mind on her work. So the first period, it was a period of any subject. Mary was trying to concentrate upon her lessons, because ultimately, who are the actual culprits? Peggy and Mary. Peggy was the first one in position to tease her, to torture her. And Mary was also equally a partner in her crime, because she was not stopping Peggy from doing this, although she was willing. But it is not necessary that if you are willing and you are, but still you are doing that thing. If you are not willing, still you are doing that thing. That doesn't mean, or that doesn't mean that you don't want to do that. She was trying to concentrate because deep in her heart and also in her mind, she was having the feeling that this must not have been done. Actually, she did not know that this kind of behavior could have happened to her. She had a very sick feeling in the bottom of her stomach. So in her stomach, she was even having a strange feeling. There was, you can say, there was a muddle of, okay, mixture of feelings in her mind that was affecting her health also. She had not enjoyed listening to Peggy ask Vanda how many dresses she had in her closet, but she had said nothing. She always thinks that she is not having this kind of feeling for Vanda, that Peggy should ask how many dresses she has. But ultimately what has happened, she has never stopped Peggy from doing all this. And she had stood by silently, and that was just as bad as what Peggy had done. And she was feeling that she is more at crime. Why? Because she is always standing quite on the side of Peggy without saying a word that you should stop that, right? So she was a card. Of course she was. At least Peggy hadn't considered they were being mean, but she, Maddie, had thought they were doing wrong. She could put herself in Vanda's shoes. Vanda's shoes mean she could feel herself at her place, okay, in her same situation. She felt that she should have stopped all that, but she was not able to stop that. She is equally a partner in the crime. She was equally wrong, and she would have stopped Peggy from doing all this. But as she has not done, that was really wrong on her part. So here the question is, sometimes a question can be asked here. You can write down the question here. How did Peggy, or how did Maddie feel when, how did Maddie feel when Miss Mason read Vanda's letter, Vanda's father's letter in the class? Please write down on the sides of the book. If you are writing it in rough, it will be lost. Next time have the book. So, how did Vanda felt when Miss Nelson read Vanda's father's or Jim Jen Petrovsky's letter in the class? okay? Or what was the reaction of many when Miss Mason read her letter? So you should completely write down. She was not able to concentrate her mind, to focus her mind in her lessons. Moreover, she had a strange feeling in her stomach. She was thinking herself to be an equal culprit in all the wrong things, whatever being done in the class. And ultimately, she thought herself to be caught. Okay? So that's... Yes? She was greatly disturbed. She was deeply distressed. Okay? Right? So that's all for today. And next afterwards, we will continue further.